As a Christian female in the fitness industry, I've seen so many women frustrated as they search for transformation through diets and exercise alone. And what I've realized is that God's word, the most important part of this life for a Christian, seems to be the portion that's always missing from what we're being taught about being fit and healthy. Courageous Fit Female is a podcast for women who love Jesus and want to get fit and healthy His way. Want to seek His truth versus what the world says? Then let's get into today's show. Welcome back to Courageous Fit Female. It is Jacqueline Castro, and today I'm making it a bonus episode, kind of writing it along with the four previous episodes. If you have not listened to the previous four episodes consecutive all in a row, it is a series all about food because I know how much food is a stronghold, not just only in my life, but in a lot of other women's lives. There's just something about food that the enemy knows he can take and use it against us and use it against what God has for us and has in store for us. God has so many plans for us. And a lot of the times it's food. Food is not the enemy. It's the walking into temptation and fulfilling the lusts of the flesh with your cravings. And then it leads to other areas of your life that just feels like you have no control when it comes to comparing the self-control or lack thereof when it comes to food. So that's the reason why I had that food series. This is a bonus episode. I wanted to come on and talk to you about the clean your plate myth. Now, I know you know exactly what this means because it's not something you only heard from your mom, but if you are a mom yourself, you have told your children, you tell them that they need to eat everything on their plate. They're not going to have dessert until they finish everything on their plate, right? And you have been told that by your parents as well, or your mom. I mean, you yourself have picked up on that because how many times have you eaten what is left in your sight? Not just on your plate, but like what's in sight. Like you look around and you're like, oh, there's still some more, there's still some more ham or there's still some more pot roast. So you help yourself with the fifth helping of that food. Right there, it just makes me think about the lust of the eyes, right? That was the temptation of Eve because that's what she saw and she was lusting after what she saw. So more often than not, that's the reason why we hear that phrase, like out of sight, out of mind. So when you buy something, it's good to put it out of sight so that you won't see it. Because once you see it, you're going to start to imagine that that food is in your mouth and you're going to be tempted even more just because you saw that thing, you saw that snack. But my question of the day is, does it make you feel better? Or worse, does it make you feel better that you ate that food or that you ate that fifth helping? Or does it make you feel worse? Does it bring guilt and shame into your day, into your life? Or does it allow you to feel the freedom that God has created you to have? Now, we're never going to truly be free until Jesus returns and He takes us up into the clouds and He saves us, right? Like He completely saves us from this world. That's not the kind of freedom I'm talking about. I'm talking about, do you feel freedom from God's word and having His word satisfy you? Or do you feel guilty that you went ahead and took that fifth helping? I mean, we're talking about cleaning your plate. Like cleaning your plate and even beyond that is getting third, fourth, and fifth helpings. For me, God has helped me pass the point of feeling guilty and shameful for getting my third, fourth, and fifth helpings because now He's given me that freedom from His word and digesting and being nourished from His word. And now He's given me that freedom knowing that I don't need that extra helping. I don't need to indulge in sugar. Now, I wanted to give you five quick tips to help you to come to a place of, okay, I don't need to clean my plate. These are some things that I'm going to be okay with. There are some reasons as to why you actually clean your plate. Like the first reason is because you were taught to clean your plate. The second reason being that you don't trust that you're going to have your next food. Like maybe I'm speaking to myself because I know that's where I have been. Like I feel like, you know, mentally, I know physically that God's really going to provide for me. My flesh takes over and I just psych myself out and I tell myself I need to eat the rest of whatever is being offered to me or whatever is available or whatever is on my plate, plus three more helpings. Because if I don't get it now, then when's the next time I'm actually going to eat it? And what God has shown me is that that is a spiritual issue. That is a heart issue in regards to, do I trust God that he's actually going to bless me with another meal? And the third reason why you have this clean your plate attitude, or clean your plate, you have to clean your plate belief, is that you heard that if you don't finish what's on your plate, can you imagine all the starving kids in Africa? Can you imagine all the starving people right out your back door in your neighborhood? The homeless people right down the street, like, they don't have food. So I need to eat the food, because how many other people are starving? And I'm blessed to have this food, so I'm just going to eat the food. I'm going to clean my plate. There might be other reasons to this, but I narrowed it down to those three reasons why you clean your plate. And that is not going to make you closer to Jesus. It's not going to bring you closer to God's word. And that is the ultimate question that I ask myself, is that when I'm tempted to eat something, I ask myself that question: is this going to bring me closer to God, or is it just going to temporarily satisfy my flesh? Am I going to feel like I'm in bondage, or am I going to actually be set free from eating this next thing? And you need to set up a plan for yourself, because if you don't set up a plan for yourself now, before you're actually in that moment, you're going to trip, you're going to stumble, and you're going to fall. God tells us to plan. He tells us to plan our ways, but have him direct our steps. So plan it. Plan out for the time that when you're about to go into that moment on the next meal, what are you going to do? These five tips that I'm going to give you, they're not like, I'm going to give you five tips to, not clean your plate. Like, my intention here is to help you to avoid or to lessen the chance that you're going to clean your plate. Because we already know, right, that when we clean our plate, that we become full, and we become bloated, and we walk towards that feeling of guilt and shame. So we want to avoid that. But if you're leaning more to the side of, I don't want to waste food, then these tips are really going to work for you. Okay. So number one is to organize your pantry and organize your actual produce in your fridge in such a way that it's going to force you to use those foods first. And that includes leftovers, because I don't know about you guys, but whenever there's leftovers in my fridge, I always try to put it up to the front, because if I cook something that night, if I don't put the previous night's meal towards the front and the most recent meal towards the back, I'm going to end up pushing the older food towards the back, right? And you get it. So I'm just going to ignore whatever's in the back, and it's going to be wasteful. That is definitely wasting food. And I believe that God does not want us to waste food. God wants us to, first of all, remember that food is a gift. And if we have so much food on our plate and we end up wasting it, it means that we got too much food on our plate. Like, our eyes are bigger than our stomach, right? We've all heard of that. So right off the bat, we need to remember that food is a gift. It's not something for us to just flippantly use at our own disposal and stuff our faces and tell ourselves that we need to clean our plate, quote unquote. If you have five donuts on your plate, are you really going to eat those five donuts? Right? We need to use common sense and use our best judgment in the situation you are given, because to some people, clean your plate might mean, hey, I'm here at a wedding. Somebody gave me two slices of cake, their wedding cake, and I don't want to waste the cake. Now use your best judgment. Sometimes I think we go beyond what common sense is because we try to justify, but our justification doesn't even make sense, because like, why would you even eat those two slices of cake when you know that it's going to make you feel sick? Side note, if you don't feel sick from eating two or three slices of cake, we have a real problem there. And I know exactly how that feels. And what it really comes down to is a heart issue. It is a spiritual issue. Remember my Faith and Food Freedom Foundations program? So for a 1-hour initial coaching strategy for $97, that's one of the main things that we go over. We try to dig in and uncover, why is it that you are so fixed and so stuck on, like, where is the self-control with food? So you definitely want to book your initial coaching strategy session with me, and let's get into it. Let's figure out where you are and why you are where you are. So again, number one, organize your pantry and produce to force you to use those foods first, including your leftovers. Number two, put a smaller amount of food on your plate to lessen the waste. So this is really obvious. Instead of trying to put something on your plate that you feel like, oh, I better get more because if I go back, then there might not be any. That means you're going to put more on your plate, more than you actually can eat. And number two is to put a smaller amount of food, right? So that you can lessen the chances of wasting food. Number three is to learn to cook the right proportions. Now, proportions meaning if you have a family of four, but you cook for a family of eight, I'm just going to say, like, for me, I cook for a family of six to seven to eight. But that's because when we eat, we complete our meal and then we pack everything up so that when lunchtime rolls around the next day, we don't have to think about what is going to be for lunch. And we don't have to work again. All the work's been done the night before. But learning to cook the right proportions is actually something that I'm trying to learn right now, because we do have some leftovers in our fridge that we do not eat, but we make it a point to offer my mom, offer my dad, you know, bless my sister with it because she's a single parent. And so it helps her to not have to think about what she has to eat because she already has her son to take care of, which is actually one of the tips that I'm going to give. So hold on for that. Now, in regards to proportions, there is an episode, number 52, if you have not listened to that, there's an app that I mentioned there and it has been life-saving. It has been an answer to my prayer. So if you haven't listened to episode 52, go ahead and listen to that. But that app is going to help you to cook with the right proportions so that you will not have waste on your plate. It's going to help you to learn how to create your own meal plan. Now just know that it is a paid app. So learn to cook the right proportions. Next one, number four, is to only buy what you need. And so think about the person that you know, maybe it's yourself, who you buy things in bulk because just because it's on sale or just because it's a good deal. And buying in bulk, there's nothing wrong with that, except that it only saves you money if you actually use the thing. So if you go ahead and buy oatmeal that is in a gigantic barrel because it was only $30, but you don't really use the oatmeal, then you just wasted $30. So buy only what you need. And the app that I mentioned, that's going to help you to work around that so that you don't waste ingredients. So number four is buy only what you need. Number five is to bless someone. So as I mentioned earlier, we have leftover food. And when we do, we bless my mom, we bless my dad, we bless my sister. We know that God's word says that it's more blessed to give than to receive. And so when you do that, I know that for me, when I do that, when I have leftover foods, I'm so overjoyed to offer my sister, to offer my mom, to offer my dad. And blessing someone can also mean packing your food. So when you pack your food, like let's say you're at a party or even just at home, like we don't really go out to eat anymore nowadays, but when we pack our food, we pack it as if it was for us, but then we actually give it to my parents or we give it to my sister. But just blessing someone with that extra food is going to be a real blessing to that individual. So you don't have to eat everything that is left inside. You don't have to eat everything that is on your plate. If you already got to that point where you think that you have to eat everything on your plate, then you just needed to put a smaller amount of food on your plate to lessen waste. And that's why I came up with these five ways so that you can not throw away food, not have a lot of leftovers that creates a lot of waste. So cleaning your plate, if you're at that point of the mentality of I need to clean my plate, that means you're putting too much amount of food on your plate. It means you don't have the right enough proportions. More than likely, you're cooking more than you need to. You have leftovers that you end up wasting because you cook too much, right? And it gets pushed to the back of the fridge. You're not putting it at the front of the fridge. You're not buying what you need. You're just buying just because of the fact that you feel like you're going to miss out on a good deal. And or you're not choosing to take the extra food, pack it, and bless someone else with it. Now, these are not end-all, be-all tips. These are just some things that came to mind and heart that I wanted to pass along to you. Because if you keep finding that you have leftover food and you feel terrible about wasting it, and you feel like you have to clean everything on your plate, these five things will help you to not have extra leftover food that it's going to go to waste. And if you cook the right enough proportions, then you won't have to clean, quote unquote, clean your plate, because you know there'll be enough for the next time around. I really hope and pray that this episode blessed you and that you take one of these or all five of them, pass it along to someone else that you know has been struggling in this area. I know that food can be a real stronghold and really show how we need God. We need to press into Him and lean into Him, because when it comes to self-control with food, It's evident that we are lacking in that area. And God is the only answer. Jesus revealed that his word is the only thing that can change. Because this stronghold of food is not a physical issue. It is a spiritual issue. It is a heart issue. And that is something that the Holy Spirit has brought to my heart and convicted me. And as the revelation came, it struck a chord in my heart. And this cannot stay with me. It needs to go out to help other women just like you listening and tuning in. Because Satan will use food as a stronghold, and it needs to stop, and it stops only with God's word. As a reminder, for only $97, 1 hour, you and I go ahead and dig in. How do you break the stronghold of food, mastering your life? The cravings that you have, the temptations that you fall into, the overeating, the overindulgence. We idolize food more than we know. So book a 1 hour coaching session with me. Again, only $97. I can help you stand on a foundation of faith, focusing on food, or we can do 6 weeks together and implement exactly what we went over during that 1 hour. Ladies, I'm telling you that I'm here for you. The season is here. The food season is here, right? Thanksgiving's coming up. Christmas is coming up. There's birthdays throughout the year. There's celebrations throughout the year. There's always going to be food around. But I want to be here for you as your coach, as your mentor, and your friend on finding food freedom the faith-led way. I'm telling you, there are so many programs out there that are going to claim to help you, but the only thing that has helped me is God's word, and I want to help you the faith-led way. So email me, and I'll set that up for you, jacklyn@courageousfitfemale.com, that's J-A-C-L-Y-N. And the other option is for $297, we can implement everything that you learn in your 1 hour initial coaching session. And every week for 6 weeks, we're going to meet for 30 minutes. I'll give you little tasks, homework in between so that you can stay accountable with food and what the world tells you about yourself and your body and confidence and all that good stuff. And as a reminder, the 6 week package is for this year only $297. And for those of you who are booking for the year 2020 for the implementation 6 week program, I do have a bonus for you. So hurry up and sign up. Let's get you going. 2021 is almost here. Let me help you plan out the year 2021 so that God can continue to use you for his glory. Okay, ladies, that wraps it up about leftovers and about cleaning your plate. If you truly did find value in this episode, please share it with your friends. Take a screenshot of this and put it up on social media, because this is the kind of stuff that I wish as a Christian that I wish I knew about. And that's why I created this podcast, so that I can help you to run the marathon of fitness and faith God's way. Until the next episode, for his honor and for his glory, stay courageous and fit.